Hello there. If there's anything I can do for you, just tell me.
Sure. Is there anything in particular that we need? Alright. You can pick me up later at Bellator's General Goods.
I timed it just right. I've been trying to get her to go shopping, but it's always at like 8 in the morning, 9 in the morning. And Bellator doesn't open until what, 10 or something? On certain days, it was crazy. Standing out in the rain, wondering if Bellator's shop is open that day or not. Oh, my Rigmore, she's almost unrecognizable. She's turned herself into some sort of angst teen. Almost goth-like, necromantic, whatever. She's been listening to some strange music lately, I suppose. It's a phase.
Need something?
Oh, that hair's messed up.
All right, then.
Sometimes it looks good. When I pick a hairstyle for someone, it looks fine, and then they go outside, they look ridiculous.
Just leave.
Same with her. Her hair looks ridiculous out here.
I just want to go home and read. Until next time.
She's turned into a nerd. But actually, she was already a nerd.
My daughter Braith says I read too much. Play with me, mother. Girls need to learn how to take care of themselves.
She needs to look more red guardish, I guess. Yeah, so I'm just goofing around. I'm addicted on these stupid little quickie mods where you walk up to somebody and you just tell them what to wear. You don't have to make them a follower. You don't have to look in their inventory. Just say, you.
Heard that one from the college.
Put this
heard
on.
About you.
Wear this. This is now your default
here,
outfit for the rest
Some of
the
Jarl's men came by and
Skyrim series.
Now, until next time.
Then I was.
Can I talk to you?
Not now, Braith.
But.
Not now, Braith.
See, now they kind of look like they're related now, sort of, kind of. But in a different way. They're more warrior, tribe-ish. They go around beating up people. Oh, what is that? I don't want to know. I don't want to know. She looks like a wild, crazy old woman. Who's this? Yeah, that's a bit much. Crystal Gale or something.
Good to see you.
Was that her name? The one who was married. I think she was married to Johnny Cash, but my memory could be fuzzy from what, you know, 40 years ago.
Hello again.
Yeah, I'll change someone's look at a moment's notice. And it looks fine for that moment. And then I see them a couple days later and it's like, what was I thinking? What a fashion faux pas that is.
You're a strapping young man. Don't be a stranger.
So I was trying out the BBLS? Is that what it's called? Busty Babes Luxury Suite. It's been around forever. I noticed they're up to version 6.2 now. And it now comes with a similar conversation topic like I'm using here, where you just walk up to somebody and you say, hey, wear this. And it works the same as this
Good
mod.
To see you. Good day.
It doesn't have all the outfits either.
Let's get some mead. Not anymore, thanks to you, friend.
But it's got the, you know, the default clothing. It's got the armor, the light and heavy armor.
Until next time.
It's got some good picks. The one I'm using here has some good picks, so using them both, you should be able to get pretty much any outfit from Skyrim onto some NPCs. Mods like this are a great fix for those times where you see NPCs walking around naked in your city, and you're like, what happened? Why?
I've been tending to the warriors of your Vasker for as long as I can remember.
And it just means that the NPC no longer has the default clothing in their inventory, though. They wake up in the morning, they want to put on some clothes, they don't have the clothes, so they just go out naked. It'd be nice if the AIs were set up so that they would just wear whatever they have in inventory, put it on. That's it. Instead of always looking for the default stuff.
I see everything, hear everything, and know everything.
That's not creepy.
Until next time.
She went to the salon.
Good to see you. Be careful out there.
One of those hair relaxer things. Oh, what's going on here? The Janessa is still a work in progress.
Hi there. I have sold everything you wanted me to sell for you.
Of course.
So she's wearing her necklace that gives her good prices on things, and she's still...
Talk later.
She's still getting lame-ass prices from this guy.
Everything's for sale, my friend. Trinkets, odds and ends, that sort of thing. Do come back.
Quickly, if you please. I'm quite busy running errands.
Whatever. Who's this?
What's the matter? You can't stand the sight of a strong Nord woman? Yeah, take care.
She looks like a hot mess.
I can tell you're no stranger to the wild.
I really like your outfit. It matches your eyes so well.
Oh no, not that again.
Anytime.
It matches my one eye.
It's a fine day with you around. Lead the way. Can I help you? What do you want me to carry?
Oh, I thought she had a whole bunch of stuff in her inventory. I guess not.
If you need anything else, just holler.
Sometimes I'll use people as storage containers if I don't have the
Still
strength.
Here.
If I don't have the strength to carry all of my belongings.
I'll head back home if you need me. Have anything interesting to tell me?
We sell bows, arrows, sure. And ale. A unique combination, to be sure.
It may be that Harriet Radiant Raymond isn't very friendly. Still, she's a lot nicer than her sister, Andari.
Excellent. Anything else?
I think Mjoll is right about the Thieves Guild. How can people who would betray one another over a gold coin...
I can tell you...
Shall I join you once more? What do you say?
All right.
Now it's your turn. You must have picked up some gossip.
You have chosen wisely. Lead on, and I shall follow.
I think perhaps...
It's the least I can do.
You must have overheard some...
Oh, she's got a bunch of stuff still.
Everyone has.
Things like bus tokens, I'm like losing, and I'm like, okay, one of my companions has my bus tokens. Where is she? You know, I could just add them using the console command, but I'd rather track down that person and say, remember when you borrowed that thing, you know, my sugar, you borrowed some sugar from me, that kind of thing. Anyway, I don't know what kind of video this is going to turn out to be. I was thinking of talking about role-playing and the how evil it is to most players. But, maybe I'll save it for another video.
I understand. Come and find me if you decide that you miss my companionship. Skyrim is out to prove that he's the equal of
Yorland Greymane. It's not really a fair comparison, if you ask me. After all, Yorland works the Skyforge. How is any smith going to compete with that?
Yes, so they say.
I'll be happy. Nah, I don't think so.
Okay.
Yeah, so on the forums, I'm still getting into arguments with people about role-playing. Never happens in other forums. I have all kinds of hobbies, and I go to forums about those hobbies. Everyone's talking about how to get better at the hobby in these forums. Except for the role-playing forum. Oh, it's like I don't understand. You know, I go into a forum, I want to learn. I want to get better at doing stuff. I don't want to regress. I don't want to go into a forum to regress, to get worse. It's like when you're 5 years old, you do finger painting, right? You finger paint when you're 5 years old. You put your hand in the paint, then you rub your hand on the paper. That's all fine and dandy. But 40 years later, you're still doing finger painting? The same finger painting? Because you've been doing it for 40 years? Don't you want to do like some more advanced technique of painting? No. The classic way of doing it is finger painting. Then you've come to the right place. We're in the finger painting forum. This is about finger painting. Anyway, that's how the roleplay forums tend to be. This is how we've been doing it.
Bows and arrows for the mighty huntsman.
This is all we know. This is. Once in a blue moon, you get it. One or two people that they want something more. They're looking for. They read that paragraph, right? In the core rule book. Of most role-playing
Thank
games. There's a paragraph that says what you're supposed to do in the game.
Like
but when you go to the forums, no one's doing that.
And it doesn't treat his wife very kindly.
I'll be happy to assist you if you
So I think some of these forums need to be more honest with their description of what their forum is about. If there's no role players in the forum, just call it the non-roleplay group. Call it the Roleplay Rule Pirates group. Because that's what a lot of these groups are, is just people going in there. What they're really looking for is where can they download games for free. That's what they say, for free. They don't say, I want to pirate the game. I just want to download it for free. So I go in there and I start haggling with people. Why are you guys pirating these games? And they come up with all these rationales for why they steal. You ever notice that? A thief will always rationalize why they steal. Their morals or their moral compasses are screwed up, that's for sure. They have this crazy idea. This one always gets me. I steal because if I like the game, then I'll buy it. Yeah, right. They don't buy anything. They just keep stealing. They like a game, they want to steal all the other stuff that goes with that game. They're not buying nothing. They can lie to themselves all day. Yeah, how am I going to know which game's good to buy if I'm not stealing them? Well, whatever. The other one they say is, well, a PDF should be free. Because internet is free, right? Data is free. Information's free. PDFs don't cost anything to make. They don't cost anything to download. You know, That's their mentality. Anyway, so I discovered that Rigmar will soul trap. And I had a suspicion that Vilya will too. Because I see a lot of Vilya in Rigmar. I don't think any of my vanilla followers can soul trap. I'd have to have a soul trap mod, I think, installed for that to happen. Like, if I give Lydia a weapon that soul traps, and I give her a bunch of empty soul gems, I'll come back a day later and all of her soul gems are still empty. But if I go back to Rigmar,
I need your help.
All the soul gems are filled up.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that's cool. And yes, Orisa's in my game. 1.3.
You see those warriors from Hammerfell? They've got curved swords. Curved swords. For that price? Sure.
I'm not even sure if Orisa will even take a soul gem from you.
If you want to buy poisons, I've heard that Saria...
Yeah, it's very limiting what Orisa can even have in her inventory.
Do you see it?
She waits for me to go into first person. I'm gonna try this in third person. Oh, she gets me. I wasn't hearing the music, so I thought maybe I need to try this again.
Nothing personal. I just need to relieve you of your coin. Take care now.
I turn around and she's gone. So now her map marker is a mile away. Yeah, so there's no music being played. Let's try again. Oh, now we got music. The files need to be cached, at least in my computer, for these things to happen. Because there's too many files, too many scripts, too many audio files trying to load up at once. Plus the animation of you getting bonked on the head. The camera lens effect when you're getting blurred vision. All that loads at the same time at when it needs it, right then. Because Chesco is a crap modder. I mean, the mods are popular, but they're just crappily made.
You have committed crimes against Skyrim and your people. What say you in your defense?
Chesco means
you,
constant restart. I think that's what
everything all right?
The word Chesco translates to. Constant
you expect
restart.
Me to believe that? I still don't like it, but I guess I'll overlook it this time.
Because most people I know that use Chesco mods, they say they get this grandiose idea that they're going to start a YouTube channel, they're going to start a series of Skyrim playthroughs, and after about maybe 5 or 6 videos, gone, they're done. What happened? Well, they were using Chesco mods. Eventually, stuff stopped working.
You know where to find
them. They didn't feel like going back to the beginning of the game to get their Skyrim to work. So they found something else to do with their hobby. Anyway, I tried to avoid using Chesco mods. More hassle than it's worth. The claim to fame was the guy would make his mods pluginable. You know, people could write plugins for his mod. Plugin friendly. Did that ever happen? Are there like a slew of plugins on Nexus made for Chesco mods? You know, like his campfire and his frostfall. Are there a whole lot of mods out there saying,
that was
you need Frostfall or a campfire or both to use this mod, you know, that kind of thing.
You have an eye for talent. Okay then, I guess I owe you. So, what do you do? Are you some kind of adventurer?
I'm just not a huge fan of frameworks.
Couldn't decide what you wanted to be when you
grew up? A lot of these modders, they get these... It's almost like a committee where they come up with some new framework.
Pleased to make your acquaintance.
They want to take over the Skyrim engine.
Or a trap disarmed,
and
I'm your woman. Stay out
their
of my
framework
way,
becomes the
out
gateway
yours.
For
so
other mods to come through into the game.
Companion. I'm ready to get out of here.
But the frameworks are crap. That's why I like mods like Vilya.
Do you need something?
She's self-contained. She isn't part of a group. There was another guy. The guy who does immersive winches, he tried doing that. He had a little framework going on. You had to install immersive winches, and then you could install all these other winch mods that were just plugins to immersive winches, and that went bye-bye. So now each mod is standalone. Keep it simple. But, you know, 5 or 6 years ago, that was the bee's knees, is to make a big conglomerate mess. All your modules had to congeal into this package platform thing. I'm so glad that's not the case anymore. I want to keep it simple. You don't want so much overhead just for a little, teeny little mod that's going to be added to the game. You know, one platform that does work, I admit, would be Sex Lab. It does the job. You know, Sex Lab is just, you know, what's going on in the neighborhood, in the immediate area of the player character. What are the NPCs thinking of doing, and what are they doing, and what are they about to do? That's Sex Lab. In a nutshell. It's not script intensive. It's animation sequence intensive. I mean, animations have to go in a certain order for things to happen.
Dot, 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 dot. Everywhere.
So the script is at the speed of animation. If you have a slow computer, the animation might be slow. But it's still gonna happen. And then Sex Lab only does that one little thing. It doesn't try to take over the game. It doesn't try to take over all the NPCs in the game. This is going to bug me to the day I die. Why Vilya? I have a suspicion why Vilya does this. The back. It goes either forward or backward.
While we're here, maybe we could do some shopping.
When she grabs a weapon. I mean, she gets fixed. If we go indoors and then come back outdoors, she's fixed. Or, I mean, not that. What is it? What fixes her? Fast travel. If we fast travel somewhere, she gets fixed. But I have fast travel turned off, so I have to live with it. She's not broken, she's just awkward. She'll still fight. She'll do all the things. Her standing idle is just awkward. Okay, now we're herding cats. Everyone to your places. Okay, Arissa's walking to her horse. You can do it! I don't have horses for vanilla characters. They would have to ride with me if they want to ride. Anyway. Yes, I've narrowed it down. The problem with my Vilya, with her back issues, I want to say it's It's the Four's new idol spells. FNIS 7.1? I think that's what I'm using. And I never, ever, ever had that problem with her when I was using 5.5, whatever, for like 100 years.
What do you need? I'm sworn to carry your burdens. Oh, wait, I'm not.
So I've been trying out different hair on Orisa. In a cave. But yeah, so in a nutshell, long story short, when I switched back to the old FNIS, Delia never had an issue coming off of her horse with a broken spine. And I noticed that other things started working again that were not working when I had 7.1 installed. Or is it 7.0? I'll have to look in the description below. Because I got Sexy Move 7 something. The creature is 6 something something. And they weren't working together.
You have a grim look. Lead us to our next task.
So I don't know. There's just too much. I don't consider FNIS a sex lab thing. But a lot of the sex lab mods require FNIS. For their animations. All FNIS does is put animations into a library folder, basically. So that other mods can easily find the indexes to all the animations. And that's all it does. And I'm still using an old sex lab. I'm using the tried true version. Not the newfangled ones that, like I was talking about earlier. Platform.
What is it?
Platform modding that tries to take over the world. And I suspect that sex lab, the newest version, is trying to do that. They're trying to incorporate a bunch of mods into one mod, so you're not downloading a bunch of little mods. And then it's like approval by committee if your mod gets it accepted into their, you know, enclave kind of thing. Because the minute I go back to the old FNIS,
not going to happen.
And the old sex lab versions of things, everything's hunky-dory. Everything works, smooth as silk. So I don't know why stuff needed to get fixed. You know, don't fix what's not broken kind of thing. But you got a lot of people playing Skyrim that aren't playing Skyrim. They want to play something else, and they do those kinds of videos. You know, showing off female player characters for mod reviews. That's what sex labs become, is a tool for doing video choreography of characters for YouTube mod reviews of outfits and body parts, things like that. Which is fine and dandy. But me, I want to play Skyrim. I want to play Skyrim in Skyrim. I just want to tweak it. I just want my Skyrim tweaked. That's all.